Tom Yawkey's involvement in this property started around 1909 when the South Island Gun Club was formed. That was a group of 15 sportsmen who bought the property to turn it into a hunting club. One of those 15 was William Yawkey, who was Tom Yawkey's father. And Tom used to come here as a young boy. In the early 1920s, Tom bought out the other 14 owners to become the sole owner of the property. And he loved it here. He spent most of the year, usually from October through May each year here. And the rest of the year, he was up in either Boston or New York dealing with business in the Boston Red Sox, the other love of his life. He came here to get away from the rat race of the business world. He spent as much time as he could here each year. And he particularly loved waterfowl. That was his real passion. He spent a lot of time managing the property for waterfowl, spent a lot of money improving the property for waterfowl management, and that was a huge passion of his. Near the end of his life, Mr. Yawkey began to think about what to do with the property. He and Mrs. Yawkey did not have any children, so they wanted a transition plan to see the property protected. So he placed in his will allowances that the property would be donated to the state of South Carolina upon his death to what was then the Wildlife and Marine Resources Department, now the Department of Natural Resources, to be managed as a wildlife preserve. With that gift, he also put several stipulations. One, that the area will always be an inviolate waterfowl sanctuary for the care and feeding of waterfowl, that the North Island portion of the property will always be a wilderness area with no human improvements, and that the property will always be an area for wildlife management, research, and education, and not for general public recreation. One of the major things that makes this property unique ecologically is our geography. We have the Atlantic Ocean on our eastern boundary. We have Winyaw Bay, which is a highly saline estuary, on our northern boundary. We have the North Santee River as our boundary on the southern end, which is a fairly fresh system. So on three sides, we have three different habitats in one location. And that's a relatively unique setup along the South Carolina coast. Yawkey Wildlife Center is about 24,000 acres. You have a real diversity of habitats. We have everything from 14 miles of beach, which have loggerhead sea turtles nesting, to freshwater managed wetlands, to brackish water managed wetlands, to longleaf pine habitats. Starting around 2011, internal discussions here at Yawkey Wildlife Center with our staff and with our trustees at the Yawkey Foundation, we decided we wanted to become more involved in directed wildlife research. A lot of research had been done over the years on our property, but primarily we were providing a study area. We weren't designing the projects that were being done. And we decided we want to pursue that path. And around 2014, we signed a collaborative agreement between Yawkey Wildlife Center, the Yawkey Foundation, and Clemson University to fund a wildlife position in research here that would do wildlife research at Yawkey Wildlife Center and at the Baruch Institute that Clemson University has up Winyaw Bay from us. In 2015, Dr. Thomas Rainwater was hired to run the wildlife research programs here at Yawkey Wildlife Center to work for Clemson University. One thing this partnership has helped with is getting students in the field. I remember as an undergraduate at Clemson in the Wildlife and Fisheries program, some of the best experiences were field trips. The classrooms are great, but you really don't get hands-on work until you go to the field for extended visits. And we've been lucky enough to be able to do that here.